I'm standing up and I'm telling you, I am Warhol. I am the number one most impact.
All right, yo.
1, 2, mic check.
Yeah, all right, turn down a little because you're fucking loud, man.
Big loud.
Don't peek it out. Journeyman.
D-Rad.
Yo, what's happening?
Yeah, I'm just chilling.
How are you doing? Bro.
Yeah, what's happening?
It's a scam call that keeps trying to come through.
What's the... Yes. How do you do it? Like this? Is it one of those scrolly ones? Again.
Scrolling in. Down again. Oh, airplane. See, top right?
Yeah.
Second from the... Yeah,
bam.
That's it.
There you go. Out.
Get out of here, scam calls.
There we go.
I don't even like you.
That's better.
We're not even your friends.
We don't even like you.
I thought we was boys.
Right. Stop ringing me.
Get off my dick.
Stop biting on my nipples.
It hurt me.
I don't like it.
Mm-mm.
So what are we doing here?
So I think it would be very, very good to tell the people about some great theories. Great theories of life.
Yeah, exactly.
Great theories of health and wealth and stuff. Welcome to Cancer.
How to look cool and smoke weed.
Yeah.
That's what this is about.
This is all about how to look cool and smoke weed.
Yeah, so if you don't know myself, my name is D-Rad MC. I'm a rapper from New Zealand, Aotearoa, New Zealand, who are now based in Melbourne. I just came here for lockdown, pretty much. I just wanted to experience, like, the closest, like, thing to South Korea without getting too far out of my comfort zone. And this is Journeyman. Speak for yourself.
Yeah, my name is the Journeyman. Most people call me Jared. I'm from here in Melbourne. I was born here, and now I live here. And I'm going to rap a lot. And the more I rap, hopefully the better it gets. But for right now, we're just trying to hang out and chat about some cool shit.
Yeah, that's it. So yeah, I don't know, like, I've been working on a project called Goodie Bag the Mixtape. It's taken quite a bit of energy and now it's basically done. I've got a little bit of free time now, so podcasting is something that I've considered doing for a while, and now it's kind of perfect timing. And then Journeyman was hanging out the other day and we were like, fuck, this is funny as shit, we should just start recording it. So
yep, just stimming the neuro untypicals,
neurodivergence.
There you go, bang. The neurodivergence
sounds like a 1970s like post-punk band.
It's an autistic buddy cop movie.
Yeah.
Who can stim better, John? Fuck. But yeah, this came up with this sick idea. Homeboy is about to drop Goodie Bag as well, so we're like, there's a good chance to plug some material and have a bit of fun doing it.
That's it.
Have you got release dates in mind?
No, I don't. I'm just trying to finish it. Once it's finished, then I'll find out how long, once you like sign up for Spotify and stuff, that's going to take, and how long manufacturing will take for physicals.
Yeah.
And then I'll probably give it, I've got 3 singles that I'll basically drop like maybe a week apart and then drop the project.
Oh, bang. So the formula's down pat.
What's that?
The blueprint's down.
Yeah. It's finished. It's just not like, I just need the last couple of masters to like be lined up basically.
Yeah. Done.
And, what was I just going to say? I've got 2 videos that are done. So it's close.
Yeah, man. So you're really fucking working.
Yeah, and I'm just trying to do it all justice, like, not right. You know, I've taken my time with every other part of the process, so I don't want to rush this last part of it. I want to just make sure I do it all justice.
How long ago did you come up with the idea of Goodie Bag?
The mixtape as a project... is maybe been... Fuck, bro. I just realized I've been living here for, I think, 2 years. So maybe like it's like 3 years old as an idea.
Fuck.
So, some of the songs are quite old. Like, as concepts, they're quite old.
Yeah.
But there were songs that I wrote that I like really liked and had potential. This is like my school report for myself.
Yeah, right.
That's how it's came true. If you'll just apply some consistency and... focus on your delivery.
Yeah.
And I, like, yeah. So the songs that I started writing from when I was still really learning how to rap, but that I wanted to, like, do justice, basically, because the writing was good on them. So I've got, like, new beats made for a bunch of old ideas, basically.
Sweet.
And redone them. You know what I mean?
That's cool as fuck.
Yeah. That's, like, my song Tinoranga Teratanga. It's one of my favourite tracks. It's, like, kind of a track about colonisation of Aotearoa. And I'd rap a little bit in Te Reo. Yeah, that was like a cool concept that my previous attempts had fallen short of what its potential was. And I think we've nailed it now, so yeah. And I've got a track called Mayo 9, which is talking about my past, like, activist life. I used to live in the trees in the Upper Florentine, blockading forests, and this one time I was in a big tree, like a 60 meter tall eucalypt tree in southern Tasmania, and like the cops came for me and climbed up and took my tree sit down, and I outclimbed them and they couldn't get me down, and I ended up getting down and escaping while they were like looking for me through the forest and stuff. So I've written this kind of like story track just about that side of my life. Yeah.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
That's some
so it's like real a real shit. Like it's a like I look at it like if I was a comic book character, Goody Bag the Mixtape is like my origin story.
Bang.
Like I've released little projects before, like an EP called Therapy, but it was really just me like learning how to operate in a studio.
Yeah.
Or like learning what I needed to learn. And this project though is like, yeah. It's one of those things I just need to get out so I can move on in my life. And also as an artist, like move on to new projects that are more like creative.
Yeah.
And like... Yeah,
but how long have you been rapping for?
Maybe like 8 years, I think.
8 years.
7 or 8 years.
Fuck yeah. Okay. Yeah. Why?
We've been over this. Because yeah. From when I was basically blockading. I mean, I've always been a writer, but from blockading, I just had, I guess, a bunch of trauma that I needed to process. And a lot of the shit that I wanted to talk about wasn't like appropriate for polite society, you know. So there was like wasn't many options for me to figure out a way to like vent the stuff I needed to talk about.
Yeah.
And I just noticed through protesting too that most of society is just like it's based on violence. Like we use paper, like toilet paper that's like old growth forests, you know, that were decimated so we can wipe our ass, and like, you know, our food comes from like, you know, oppressed migrant workers and like all this crazy shit. Like our lifestyles are based on violence. Basically, oppressing less powerful entities, basically. And we never get to talk about it. Like, it's never an honest conversation about, like, these facts. We're all just expected to, like, smile and nod and go to work and, like, just accept everything, you know?
Right.
So, yeah, after seeing the realities of, like, watching a forest get bulldozed for 2 weeks when I was in a tree sit one time, like... That kind of never left me, you know. It's like that's the reality of our society, but most people, it's hidden, you know. And I just think that we can never advance as a society or as a culture until we expose the shit that's hidden.
Immaculately insightful.
Oh, thanks, buddy. Not enough jokes in there. But
no, but you don't
right.
need a joke in
there. Yeah.
And that's some real shit, people.
Yeah.
I can't fucking say anything like that.
What do you mean? Of course you... Of course
that
you
ain't mean. My life.
But your life has its own story. And yeah, that story does. Is just as valid as anything else in the world, you know?
Well, it's just as unvalid as everything ever. It's
therefore...
just nothing. So it's like, I'm a nothing person. And it's fine.
Well, I would discourage you from putting yourself down, though. Because
why?
Because it's invalidating your experience. And your experience is just as valid as Mother Teresa or Gandhi or anyone, you know?
Yeah, but I'm one of those
bastards
that invalidates all experience. Because I can't get over my own existential crisis. That's me, though. Like, it's a different wave. Like, I'm on this, like, really, really cool, pathetic shit. That's my vibe right now. Because this is all I know, dude. This is all I fucking know. I, like you, rap therapy.
Mm.
Rap is therapy for me because I don't want to talk to people about the things I actually want to talk to them about. So
yeah,
because
they go, oh, that's not cool.
Mm, yeah, but also just kind of...
But if you can rap it in a way where it's undeniably cool sounding, then you force people to engage with like whatever topic, right?
That's what's so sick about it, is just like how do you make authentically you sound cool to people? Rap is sick. Like imagine like
it's
trying
hard.
To like
this
so fucking hard.
It's like it's potentially impossible.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like my dad never loved me. And we were poor growing up. Yes. Like no one wants to hear that. But then it's like some dope, you break down language in a way that makes it just undeniably cool, and it, you know, it gives your story like a platform, I guess.
I find it cool the way you in particular can communicate and rap with a lot of syllable, heavy syllable rhymes, multi-syllable rhymes,
yeah,
a lot of double entendre. Like the way, like, you get on your rap shit, you're a rapper's rapper because you rap to rap in a way that makes it so like a perfectionist-y thing, which is sick.
Yeah.
But like, I look at that and I go, see, if this is you not at your full potential, right?
Yeah.
Knowing the shit I rap about and how I feel about my raps, right? I go, I could probably get that far at best. Whereas this is you just hustling your first fucking mixtape. This is crazy.
But no, it's crazy you're saying that, because I've got so much better in the last 6 months. It's ridiculous.
Good.
Like, I know, but that means that that's everyone has that potential.
Yeah.
So there's no limit to how good you can be. You don't need to compete.
No, I don't like... Why it's not like an like actually that? Limiting. It's more like I'm trying to judge it in my brain logically. Not logically, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
I'm not limiting. It's more less limiting. It's more like understanding how far you are, how far you've been.
Right,
8 years, knowing how you're doing this.
But how long have you been rapping?
4.
Yeah, okay. So
half the time, so 4 and 8. Yeah.
So you'll be in another 4 years. You'll be better than where I'm at now, in my opinion.
Thank you. I mean, more so from the point that like I see it like. With 4 and 4, it's like I look up at the next 4 years of my life, seeing where you're at already, and it's kind of like a really sick reflection of like, if you can really think about your raps and dissect your shit, you can get competitive in the terms of how good it could be. That's what's interesting. It's just like seeing how you can rap and break down raps and do it in the functionality you're doing it, but so perfect. Like, 3 years to make a mixtape, bro, that's effort. That's a fuckload of effort.
Yeah.
I've never put effort in my rhymes that way because I'm really, really trash at keeping up any time management or a schedule. So if I've got an idea if I want to make songs, it takes me forever because one day I'm going to have that just right amount of energy aligned to do it in that day. I just make music as like a splash of thought and then go... Yeah, whatever. Because I don't want to mix and master. I don't want to necessarily go into stuff. I'm almost afraid to take the next step. And you're at that step.
Yeah.
And I looked at... It's like, that's an experience jump. It's above me in ways of experience.
It's not...
So I look at that and admire it.
Right. I appreciate that. Mm. Yeah. Sorry, I mean, I don't mean to deflect your...
No, you're good. I'm sorry.
I shouldn't have done that. But, Yeah, what I've learned is it's more of a psychological step than anything else. It's like there's something about like the commitment it takes to like I've took there's songs on this mixtape like Evil, which fucked me, man. Like I thought it was gonna be a quick song, you know. I thought it was just gonna like it was a concept track, I just wanted to quickly slam it out, and it honestly took me 3 months every day, like while working, having a job, going to events, coming back home. All my spare time, I was fucking working on this because I had the vision of what it was going to be, but I fucking didn't know how to get to it until I was there. Fuck, why did I start talking about that?
Keep going.
The time, fucking time investment, I think I was talking about. Oh, yeah. Like, during that process, like, there's no guarantee, technically, there's no guarantee I'm going to get to that point where I love it. And I've invested like 2.5 months. You know, that last month, if I'd stopped at 2.5 months, that song would be terrible. But I kept going that last 2 weeks or 2.5 weeks of just like forcing it out and like making it good.
And it makes all the difference.
But it's about the psychological belief that you'll make a dope song, that you won't stop until it's like complete, you know?
Mm.
Because like, you know, I've definitely like woken up some days and be like, why the fuck am I rapping? Like, what's, you know, like that self,
do every day.
If you allow that self doubt, it's like, I put so much time into this.
Yeah.
What the fuck am I doing? You know what I mean?
If, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, that's a real threat to success. It is. It's a real problem.
Yeah. Facts.
Big facts, man. You know what I mean? So it's more about the psychological commitment to, like, believing that you will be great.
Yeah.
Than anything else. That's the biggest barrier to success, I think.
Can you break it down further?
Because
that's interesting.
Well, if you believe, like, if you will, if you believe that you, if you truly believe it, like, that you'll achieve something, then whenever an obstacle comes up, and if you've, like, manifested it, you know, whenever an obstacle comes up, it's not going to deter you. It might, like, be a hurdle, but you're still going to, you're like, well, this is my destiny.
Mm.
You know, I'm not going to stop. Like, sure, I fucking need to work so I can eat for, like, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
But, like, this is just an obstacle. It's not, like, a reason to quit.
Yeah.
I think people fail to, like, often, in general, not just music, but in life, they fail to, like, really want the thing. I think generally most people are actually afraid of success, because what's the consequence of success? Like, then what?
Mm.
That's why so many successful people get depressed, because there's no more reason to, like, most working class people are kind of blessed in a way that, like, they don't have time for the existential crisis, you know, like, but to really, like, get to the point where, like, you don't have, like, an urgent thing to do in the morning and you have to deal with yourself. That's the main thing. I think, honestly, I think a lot of people stay unsuccessful on purpose, so they always have something to complain about and some excuse for being unhappy. Like, and that's honestly, because I come from a... It's true, though. I think, like...
I agree.
I come from a really, like, hardcore leftist background, and that, my like, I kind of came to that conclusion through a lot of, like, spiritual awakening shit I went through, and, like, through, like, surviving trauma and stuff. And that, my new understanding of life, which I 100% believe is true, is very alienating to, like, my past community. But, like, and I'm willing to be wrong, but, like, I think it can't be denied, you know? I think a lot of people get attracted to left-wing politics, particularly because they're underachievers. And it kind of, they're like, I can't succeed because of the patriarchy. Capitalism's oppressing me.
Right.
You know what I mean? But then, like, you look at hip-hop, like, those people, the people that created hip-hop, DJ Kool Herc, like, he was one of the more oppressed people in America at that time. You know, like, it wasn't cool to be from Jamaica. At that, like, having that accent wasn't, like, trendy at that point. It was just something to get bullied for, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But it's, like, that's what I love about hip-hop, as opposed to, like, my previous identity, kind of, which was, like, just leftist, like, politics and stuff, because hip-hop's all about flipping anything negative, flip it, you know? And your pain will become your strength.
Yeah.
If you want it to be. Right. But most people, they just want it out. Yeah.
Absolutely.
What do you
fuck? I'll be thinking.
What do you reckon? What do you think about?
In terms of what?
I don't know. What's your goals? What are you up to?
My goals. I want to make money.
Yeah.
To live, but it's like my own shit, so I want to sell a trade. So whether it be like, I used to barber, used to fucking cut hair.
Oh yeah.
Didn't go well.
Why?
Don't have attention to detail.
Yeah, word.
Mm. So I was like, fuck that.
We need to make neurodivergent hand signal way. Neurodivergent. Don't fuck with me.
very much that.
Neurodivergent. I see things differently. Don't fuck with me.
I'm fucking out of my space 100% of the time. I float around.
Yeah.
But like, fuck, where was it going?
Well, I'm thinking about your goals, like a guidance counselor at high school.
My goals in life. So I want to be the biggest dick swinger with the most honest intentions.
Yes.
That's what I want to be.
Dude, that should be your bio for Journeyman. The biggest dick swinger with the most honest intentions. Journeyman.
That's what I want to be.
Roll promo.
But at the same point in time, I just want to chill, and I want to be a very, very good man. I want to be a good man. One day I want to be a great man. No, I wouldn't say great. Do you know what I'd say?
You don't want to be great?
No, pause. I don't want to be the best man. I don't want to be the greatest of all time. No, no, no. I don't want to be any of those. Do you know what I really want to be?
Tell me what you want, what you really, really want.
I want to be... Shit, I want to be really bad. I want to be the worst ever. Because the worst gets more attention. And I'm a nutty boy.
Like you want to be the shiniest Tekashi 6ix9ine?
I want to be worse than Tekashi 6ix9ine. I want to be Jared Luke Maloney.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you feel me? Because, like, Tekashi has some work ethic. I don't have shit. I'm a dickhead. So I think it makes it neat that I've got really, really honest intentions. It makes rapping easy.
Like,
having honest intentions
for
people.
Are you saying that you got honest intentions of mediocrity?
I've got honest intentions for people and everything and myself and that. So no, I've got...
Yeah.
I've, like... This is the thing. I got... This is going to sound super fucking gay. Please hear me out. It's going to be super gay. Just give me 1 minute. So...
Sorry, we just got a call from whoever you've been cancelled.
Yeah, yeah, there we go. This is the first one, all right?
You're out of here!
What I would like to say is, being such a big gaybo, right, as a youth, till now, just a big gaybo, chilling out in my little closet with all my girlfriends, right? And I found my favourite person in the whole world, who's a woman, and I tell you this, I found out the day I was bisexual, the day I met that girl, and... It's weird liking pussy when you think you don't like pussy. Do you know what I mean? So it's weird. I've sort of been this asexual shell for a long time where I was kind of like, I don't really know. I'm like, fucking's really not for me, but like, I do want to fuck sometimes. And I don't know where I'm going with this. These were my goals. These were my goals.
I just want to...
You can have that tangent, guys.
I want a year.
You want a year? First of all...
I was trying to summarise your goals.
I'm trying to deflect this. All right, so first of all, what are your goals? What are your goals?
Well, I set a goal to be the best lyricist in Australia and in New Zealand. And I gave myself 2 years. And what I learned is...
Ambition!
what I learned is that people get a lot less done in a year than they think. Because most of the time you spend fucking around and then you're like, oh, okay, I gotta be serious. And then you start really focusing. But fucking shit, there are hurdles and shit does take longer than expected. But like, that was my intention behind Goodie Bag, to show everyone that I'm actually the best at... I don't think I've got the best delivery or the best flow, maybe, or the best, tone or whatever, but I think that I have the best lyrical style in Australia and New Zealand.
You've got no doubt in your mind.
I have doubt. Like, there's definitely people that are better than me. But I believe...
But that's the way, like, you're manifesting that. You're manifesting it all.
There's people that I'm like, God damn it.
Yeah, for sure.
And, like, obviously for a lot of people hearing me say that, it sounds absurd because I'm an unknown, like, whatever. But that's what I think is dope about hip-hop, is that it's a meritocracy and that, like, a lot of people don't get attention based on they're not in the cool group or whatever. And I've never been in the cool group. But I think that by focusing on a skill set... And making, like, and really, like, focusing on it, you can, like, it doesn't matter if you're not in the cool group, but, like, if you can achieve, like, undeniable skill, then that people relate to, like, in their hearts and their brains, then you can overtake everyone. And that's my goal in life, is to overtake everyone. Because, like, in my mind, it's like, I started late. I'm like, I spent, like, fucking my whole 20s trying to do the right thing for the world. And look where that got me, fucking nowhere, you know? Like, so now I'm like, fuck it, fuck everything else. Like, I just want to rap. I believe I can be the best rapper. Like, so yeah, that's my goal. Like, that's honestly my goal. And then everything else kind of feeds into that. Like, that's what I love about hip hop is that, like, to be the best rapper, I have to be healthy. I have to be fit.
Mm.
Like, I have to look good. You know what I mean? Like, I have to care about my presentation if I want to be an entertainer. So it motivates me to, like focus on meditation and focus on exercise and, like, yeah, focus on making money. Like, because what I really learned from, like, 10 years of activism is that nothing matters. Like, all the campaigns are fake. Everyone's just trying to make a career, or they're just trying to be around a cool group of people. Like, and I thought activism was the answer to society being fake. Then I realized all the campaigns and all the whole activist shit is fake as well. I'm like, I'm going to kill myself because there's no point of life. But now, you know, out of that, I was like, nah, instead of doing that, I'm just going to decide what the point is. You know, the point is to, like, it's kind of like spiteful. I'm like, fuck you all. I see through all your shit. And I'm about to fucking demonstrate that by being extremely successful.
Talk to him. Okay.
That's how I feel, because it's like all these taboos don't serve us, you know? It's like, oh, you can't say this, you can't say that, it's bad for everybody. And it's like, why is everyone caught up in this shit, you know? It's just it's restrictive.
Yes,
you know,
sir.
What I mean? And yeah, they just, honestly, I think most, like, 90 fucking whatever percent of activist shit is literally people just trying to belong to a group. No one cares about winning campaigns. Nobody does. Like, I guarantee you, anyone that's ever given you shit online, on Facebook, trying to police your behavior or what shit you post, anyone who's doing that, has time to do that, is not campaigning for anything. Because anyone campaigning for something has no time. They have negative time. I didn't get Facebook until I'd quit activism. Until I was like, I actually got bail conditions that I was unable to protest anymore. And I was like, well, I should get Facebook so I can organize a fucking festival at least. Like, because I need to be able to contact people. I've been out of society for like 4.5 years. But yeah, that's the truth. Like, everyone's just fronting. You know what I mean? And I feel like it's this weird responsibility to reveal that.
Bro, you got the comic book origin story.
Yeah. Yeah, it's, I know. Yeah.
You need to rap a lot more often.
I know.
All the time, in fact.
Yeah, it's like, I'm really looking forward to having this project out, and I'll be free, you know, and then I can just, I've got my next project, like, 80% written, but, like, I really just want to take some time and, like, settle into my new self, you know? Like, I've been shedding a lot of people who, like, culling a lot of people who don't serve me, and don't serve my new goals yet and stuff, and, like, a lot of people are mad about that. They feel like any transgression from their, like, Puritan narrative is, like, becoming a bad person or, like, falling off, like, the righteous path. And I think it's the opposite. I think my focus on myself and my art is the way I become the best me. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. And
for me to do that properly is to, like, not compromise on it. Like, I have to do it. I have to do it genuinely. It's, like, my duty, like, to do my art properly and give that to the world. That's how I justify it anyway, because, like, it was hard, man. Like, being a full-time activist is fucking hard, because you internalize all these ideas that if you don't do it, no one's going to do it and the world's going to end, you know?
Yeah.
And it's all made up. Like, the world's not going to end. You can do whatever you want.
Is your name the teacher?
Yeah. Nah. But I'm a
teacher and the preacher?
Yeah. I do have a lot of shit to say, I guess, which is why, you know, like, why I wanted to start podcasting, because raps take me a while to write, and it's nice to just be able to just spout off.
Talk to him.
Talk to him!
Talk to him. You got a lot to say. Let's say it.
We're at almost at 1,000 bars. Let's get 1,000 bars.
1,000?
That's the length of my mixtape, actually. It's like 1,100 bars.
I thought in a night, 1,000.
Have you seen the DJ K Slay project with 100 rappers on it?
Nope.
Fuck, man. We should, like, maybe later, another time, we should do, like, a reaction to it. But it's, like, 45 minutes long. It's, like, not a feature film, but it's, like, a short film.
Right.
And he's just, like, at the start, he's, like, who are these people saying that... people are always saying they're doing it for the culture. What culture is that? The same culture that you, like, you fucking deny and don't do the education on. Like, and he's like, I'm about to teach you some shit, and you better listen, or I'll come back with more next time. It's so dope. And it's honestly, it's 100 rappers. And it's like some of the oldest rappers from the Bronx, too, that are like unknown, but like have just been rapping consistently since the beginning of hip hop, since like 78 or whatever it was.
I would really like to see that shit.
Yeah, it's cool, man.
Dude.
Should we just watch it?
Yeah, let's watch it.
It's on, I think it's on there.
Alright.
It's fucking dope, man. 100 rappers!
100 rappers. 10 push up. 10 line. Go.
Ow. Yeah. So anyway, before we get this sorted, what's like your main motivation to rap? Like, out of any, like, why are you not a painter? Like, what's it? Is it like your love for words? But like, why rapping?
For some reason, it makes the pain feel cooler.
Yeah, because you're like, now I've got this.
Yeah, it almost became like a shift in my brain at one point where it was like, okay, well, if I do this, the more that I do this, it actually makes me feel more me. And right. I'm like, oh, okay, I'm kind of like centered now. So music kind of like helped me feel out myself, but that's why it's like lethal if I don't rap authentically as well, because then it becomes a shell of me.
Yeah.
That becomes the hard bit, and I've done that before, so and it's like...
Yeah, I feel you're like setting false intentions or something.
Oh, yeah,
like,
definitely.
You can't, like, put that out there, it's not real.
Yeah, I've put up facade after facade over the course of my life, so it just got to a point where I was like, all right, we can keep lying or we can just get with it.
We can keep lying, or we can start trying, bitch.
Yeah, for real.
For real. Yeah, I resonated that. Like, way before I even heard about rap music, you know, and I was just like an unhappy kid at times, you know, and I'd just write about it.
Mm.
And I was like, this is cool.
Yeah, right.
It's like turning bad experiences into gems, you know. I think that's why I started being good at, like, explaining difficult, like, complex concepts and stuff,
right.
Because I was just always, like, working on it. Like, working on, like, knowing how I felt about something, you know?
Well, you are very articulate.
Thanks, dude.
And communicable. So, like...
Communicable.
I find people that write have different patterns within themselves to be actually more aware socially and a lot of different ideas, because they can start developing thoughts and opinions based on their previous thoughts.
Yeah, it's like building, right? Actually, I remember that's like one of the other reasons. It was like, you know, it's like most people are consumers only.
Mm.
Like, they'll work and then they'll go buy food from the supermarket and then they'll go watch and they'll consume art.
Yes.
Like a TV show or something. And it's like, you can do that. But after a year of doing that, you have an understanding of that show, maybe, but you haven't created anything. But if you just every day work on something of your own, like to be creative every day, after a year, you know, you have a lot. You know what I mean? So it's like, I kind of think I realized that early in life. It's like, there's a lot of downtime, and like, I kind of want this to count for something. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Should we check this trap thing out?
Yeah, definitely.
Back to 10 music. Man, y'all did it with this one here, y'all. People love to use that quote. I'm doing it for the culture. But what culture is that you're talking about?
What you talking about?
The one that you claim is a hip-hop artist but won't do the research on hip-hop history? Or the one where you disrespect, disconnect, and disregard the founding fathers? But you know what? Whatever it is, it don't even matter. Because as long as I'm alive, I'm going to show and prove where this culture came from and what it's really all about.
I got you, man. Yo, and yo, count the 10 and then come in shoot. Fuck peace, silverback, the new Huey Newton. I feel it, it's in the air. White cop with a stare, new judge in a chair. The shit hitting the fan, but me, I'ma be smart and legalize my shit. And I ain't leaving the house without that in my hand. And it ain't only the cops, it's niggas on your block. I talk like a little bitch and act like they your man. Something like Chris Parker, my Uzi weigh a ton. 100 niggas on the track, then you know I'll be the one to tell niggas to suck cop. Run and get a gun, that's OP, new P, probably laying in the sun, probably on the P.I. If I call you king, I ain't talk about rap, nigga, that status go to B.I. You can fuck around and get murdered like a C.I. More bars and jail, nigga, who trying to get a
you
B.I.
You dealing with stock owners, conversations with stockbrokers, make a call for coke, smoking dope from a crop grower. The block knows, Kush got a funky sock odor. How could you not notice I come from that rock culture? Star the squad, but they cannot coach it. Louis Vuitton holster. This for my niggas in the salon. On they wall, they got a Nicki Minaj poster. The talk's over, no drive-bys, we walk over.
Cop bandana tied to the end of the AR. Iller than they are. Rhyme so sick, give them the day off. This is the chaos. Nicholas Cage face off. The Dark Knight, I'm making a dark night when I'm getting that KO. Better than whoever done it. Even officers better run it with the drum. I got a technique that'll give 1,200. Now the table turn. To whom it may concern, I used to control more shooters than David Stern with Lucifer.
Yo, I was in a box with a yeah. On the platform, pad leather, tops in, space invader hats on. 80-something, I've been a threat for that long. Where a lot of people get poked up and clapped on. My job really putting on for the city. You can pop like a willy for saying some old silly shit to me. It'd be safer to say it in SWAT. Hilly, they be willing you away if you say it in South Philly.
Look, 30 shots, I'm shooting the pillar's top. When them niggas sending shots, they shooting to get the spot that I'm in, nigga. You know what it is when I spin a block. Up in this drink. The witness is still in shock. Fluff from the brink of this jail, I told the plot. Tucking the strip, you get where you getting shot. Niggas still waiting for me to drop. I rob niggas for their bases, so easy rock. Fur coats and magnums come through the hall with the big glamours. Ben take his park, let me handle this. Dirty, that's flashy. Jeans is 1,000, he's slick, nasty. Pull out 100 in your housing. Yeah, it's raw lingo in the Kango. Dutch lick, nuts, big as shit, taste the rainbow.
Yo.
Put your paper up and threaten shit. Or tie something up, send some messages.
Hey, yo, I used to tell a maid. Money side up. Basement, a chainsaw, money tied up. Paper bag over his head, so unlet the cracks out. Wave a whole chicken by his legs near the crack's mouth. Sweating bullets in the chair, blow toss in his flesh. I seen his face melt. Drip gooey shit on his chest. Watch his motherfucker beg for mercy. Should've let his wind suck my dick for the time he jerked me.
Man. The soldier eye rolls with the coldest click. Call me prototype, never had a mold to fit. My clothes is dipped, my bros is lit. Only time you been sick is when the COVID hit. Better get in line, I chop the bass like I'm pitching dimes. Code name, Coffee Bean, how I hit the grind. Precision design, exquisite with the vivid shine. I'm like a European watch on a different time.
I used to run around with a Mac-10 back when I was 20 years old, that was back then. 30 clip in a 40 movie, like 50. Man, I hustle like Nip in a
Papoose is always good, like, oh yeah, rapping. I'm rapping and doing algebra at the same time. You guys are useless. He's like an actual genius that just raps as well, you know? He's like
just when I thought it was getting there. I was like, we're hitting peaks level. Yeah, right? I'm getting there, and then it's just like, oh, the Papoose is in it.
Yeah. Papoose is in it. It's like, oh yeah, I've got a rap, whoops. But I'm also going to do a number scheme with props. Like, obviously.
Yeah, I've got to step your game up. Papoose running the town.
He's like the school teacher of rap, eh?
He is...
Like, I don't know. Karis one's like the philosopher, and he's. Oh, what were you
That's the god body. Yeah, that's
yeah,
god.
Yeah, yeah. Like, Rakim obviously is like the actual god or whatever, but he's like, okay, I've been studying Rakim, and you kids need to learn how this new scheme. You know, when he rocks up with a verse that like breaks down the new concept?
Dude.
It's like he's making points. His substantive, he's got points he's making, plus he's doing schemes, plus. Like, there's schemes inside the number schemes he's doing, right? Yeah. And then he's like, but I'm going to carry a number scheme through the whole thing as well. Fucking psychopath.
Dude, the dude's just... He's like rap personified. Papoose is Papoose
old school,
is rap.
Like boom bap.
It's like rap. That's Papoose, man. It's not... It's like hip-hop and rap. This is rap.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, she's different.
Rhythm and poetry.
Fuck. Oh, I'm scared. I'm scared. Here we go.
I was born in the 70s, grew up in the 80s, got the Mac 90, then I went crazy. Through the mathematics, y'all can't compete. All by myself, I'm 100.
I was on the first 50, now the power's at a dollar. Politician pushing track, Senate, mayor, I president in it. Till it's 100, think you grounded and get punished. This is the second time Slay needed my 2 cents to keep it 100. How you want it? Fake and be a model for this matrix. They gon' turn up the AC and charge you for the blankets. Lux first lean, got you stuck standing there like you had a stop sign waiting for it to turn green. What you mean? My soul is never for sale. My youngin' just did a 12. He home, even in bells, wishing well. Me and moms on different times. Hey, crime from nigga crimes. I'm fine to spittin' rhymes. Read the signs. Body language is loud. Powers hang with the crowd. I ain't never changing my style then and now. Before that was all that. Fall back. Officials, what you call
I'll be
that?
I'm a third coast legend. Dirty South icon. Shutting shit down. Soon as they cut my mic on. From the first bar down to the last syllable. Niggas that thought they were immortal, find out they kill
to be learning about, if you want to be just, it's like free school, you know, if you want to like learn more about language, like there's so many like opportunities within hip-hop just to like study, you know, like by example of like, these are some of the best writers on earth, you know.
Yeah,
I think
is the Jizzer in there?
I don't know, I can't remember.
Dude,
it might be
crazy.
Yeah, and it's like people say these days that like hip-hop's trash. It's like, no, commercial hip-hop's trash. It's always been trash. Commercial anything's generally been shit, but there always will be like this underground, like the actual strong lyricists, you know.
Yeah.
Once I see blood, I'm like a great wife. Get you slipping on a late night, and there's no bark, straight bite. Watch you bleed out as reality starts to sink in. Try the triple OG, what was you thinking?
I give the coke to your crew, the butter's crazy. Uh-huh. Fallopian tube, just cut it, baby. Woo. Gordo, butterfly collar, cover the Cuban. She needs pads like you, and I hope you know what you don't. Look, some pay 4-5 series. I come through 4-5 series.
I used to be up in the tunnel like 100 deep, screaming our trace, soon wound with a bunch of beats. Never tied our shoes, but every night we were running streets. Nigga fuck growling, it was nights I heard my stomach speak. Then I started pumping that bass like they done a beat. Never let shit slide, cause they might think something sweet. Nigga, if July shots get hot like summer heat, when I pop up, niggas turn vegan, they never want to eat.
I know these streets with my eyes closed, so my worst fear is to die slow. Lie low, cause in 05 you flipped a 5-0, and I know, cause if Alpo did it to Rich for some bricks, what a flex. He had no reason to lie. Right,
what the fuck?
On the past, devilish laugh, I will spend some ahead of the trash, better than class. When you handle your beef, settle it fast, meddling mass, but still keep an elegant class.
Who the greatest all time? Where them niggas reside? I say ain't all 50 names, better them niggas the lot. I take the first 48, make the niggas
retire.
Right.
Oh my god,
just making niggas my squad, fuck them. Let's see how the ladies fare. Swerve on these bitches like I'm setting my baby hair. They feel a tight way, but they never gonna take it there. They trying to keep it cute, because they know that it's
all weak and creep and stealth shit. Yeah. When I come from under the belt with a melt shit. Yeah. Forever, numb, I never felt shit. I still got that real world job. Nigga, chill off. Body on my arm, warmer in my arm.
Cool.
When you get the storm before the calm. OG and we treat it like Vietnam.
He drank 40 ounces, the old English, he needs to pay. Y'all niggas drink white clothes, nigga, we ain't the same. It's curfew whenever I come through. Kill a fuckery, them niggas can't fuck with me.
Come on.
I'm really battered in the wall. Taxidermy, you bitch, head mounted on the wall.
It's M.O.
Throw it up, nigga, we stand tall.
It's M.O.
Y'all know what the fuck we stand for. It's M.O.
Never follow the script. It's movie time, release the clip.
tripping, have a doing the flip. Off white virgin, me a whip with the interior crib. I'm in the give and go to slide, nigga, minus the slip. Checking niggas out of line, like it ain't nothing to skip. Sipping my six and trying to flip, and end up getting your strip. Too many niggas want to dime, I go to sink and they
we're
skip.
7 minutes in, bro. Come the trip, I never this is like more content than most people talk about.
In the store, my face had the hatred in it. Moms had the colorful money with the staples
in it. We should do another version.
On the street and I stayed committed. Moving white back and forth over green like table tennis. Rock was pouring in, my Glock was roaring at 19. Shots hit you like hydroxychloroquine. I'm still 40 with the 40 close. In the 840 playing new E40 with some horny hoes.
Finally, y'all been waiting to hear a verse for the economy stimulation with Bible verses forsaken and tribal authorization.
We're watching
as we awaken the monsters across
the
nation.
This the whole way through. We're a quarter of the way through.
The showgun, the showgun, to who testifies. The show something, host something that electrifies. N1LB, no one left behind.
I think I should leave it like that because then
to give you the shot when I vodka the Glock a blocker the glue the dot. You want attention, I give you the spot. I run up on your favorite artist aiming at him like do the drop. I snap the cobble out of gobble and blogger toggling robbers on my saliva as hot as a pot of lava and grabber. My mama's been
this is so dope,
gobble, gobble, trying to get the drop guava interior
straight off the ball, straight off the ball, straight off the motherfucking ball for who's setting it off. Blocks where they spark a lot, click where the Glock a lot, catch you at the parking lot, park you in your parking spot. Niggas know it's sex money, vex money, they do a lot. What's better than more leathers and Buddha spots? Buck 50s for niggas that'll do a lot. Go ahead and get your shooter shot.
Shag D's front if you want. Flow through the spirit of Kobe, I don't puffin' no brunch. My estate got a shuttle, you punks. Funny thing, I got places in my face. I ain't discovering much. I naturally hover above on my cow L.
It's Chet!
Down in the arena, the cow shell.
Is
you
killing him, man? Is that not Shaquille O'Neal?
It's Krispy Kreme.
Is it? That's Shaquille O'Neal! Oh, it is! Oh, Jesus! What the fuck is
destruction, things of mass destruction. This how I leave niggas area. Me shacking guns, nothing scary. A nightmare on Elm Street when I hit the booth. A motivational speaker when I spit the truth. I come down to Pensacola if you need some proof. I can make you smile up like a missing tooth. Ahead of my time, but still a league of my own. I tried to quit, but they just won't leave me alone. If you ain't got the right price, stop calling my phone.
I'm looking for
God, the king of the throne.
Oh, man!
Hey, yo, what up, Red Alert?
I don't think they ready for this.
Well, they gonna jam up, because I ain't done.
When you hear the shot, I'm not documenting. I'm truth-documenting. I'm one of the Beatles, how I'm whipping from the linen. Bye-bye, hater. Real niggas winning. The 4th of July, don't tell me I'm independent. I'm killing it, bro. My motor, locomotive. 0 to 99, like my Netflix loaded. Tell your boss, Brick City Boys is fire. Never mind, half of y'all be talking through the wire.
Media slandered me, so that's why I'm slaying you niggas. Never knew I hit him, got the doc X-ray. You niggas touch you to a victim and I sprinkle some Yale. You niggas, they thinking he's drug related. Got a whale, you niggas all on the radio with the beat. Got him sweating like they was keeping. It's never gonna be peace. I'm shooting up your album release. Bagging bricks with your niece, come and get you a piece. I'm come taking on responsibility for the murder increase. It's buck.
They wanted me to be one of the buck because I've been a buck. Back when a pack of new puss was a buck, I was a young buck. On the corner, I'm out of keep from far out copping over the turnstile. Set a chop up top by the Jamaican spot. My turns have been a bomb. I'm vinyl cassettes, CG and streams on every wire. Loser boulevard, they paying homage to the shooter from Queens. Right now you wanna be this classic from Queens. Facto, come from special fleas to my wallaby supreme.
Each one image is unblemished without one gimmick. In line of scrimmage, I cross it in one sentence. The core writer for those that lost sight of the promenade. Now heed the words of the poor righteous that build with mathematics for those who path is empty. But y'all know math was in me for the past half a century. Now do the knowledge how the real writers do it. Cause I want the smoke, charcoal, and lighter fluid.
Talk shit, but I can back up game. Where you silly motherfuckers on the mic talk the same old same. How you wouldn't hesitate to kill, buck, rat, attack. Action if you set the shame, say fuck that. Bullshit, I'm not the one to get with. Pressure gets a pile, I give it a fuck what I hit. I play your songs like a lullaby, put me to sleep. When I see it like a pussy that's this deep.
KRS is big and scary. I'm that legend, getting cream.
Legendary.
Hear me, I rock this, shock this, hip-hop this. Awoken away, optics, rappers are not this. The hotness, I would knock some of these rappers out, but you can hear they already.
I'm unconscious.
I got this, oh. On the top list. Think I'm not this, temple of hip-hop, rising to the top, kid.
Every verse is a persecution, it's murder music. You get cursed and ruined, Slay called me to get the hearses moving. Fire shit, you get burned in ruins, it's burning fuses. Punches designed to hurt a human, losers deserve these bruises. Nobody telling me that it could never be somebody better. I got a vendetta, I mean every word of me opposition. Designed to put these rappers out of commission. All the speed is dope and after this y'all gon' need intervention. Taking the best and dropping ambition. Look at the twister, how I be killing them like I'm a woman. So now make a sweep and I'm doing a murder. And
I'm fucking twister. I'm
never do. I'm dead, I'm like a
fucker. I'm the bonus with the
flow. It don't matter which bar bitch you win. I can reorganize the confusion of a child pharaoh. Not macho, that food for thought from the Prisco pit from the ghetto. I am approaching, so I hope you're using the radar. Causing beautiful chaos in this unusual seance.
If you trigger finger, watch me finger, fuck it. Niggas bust and squeeze the biscuit.
Alright.
The minute thing is muffin, repercussion. All the homies, niggas spray the corner. Now they falling on the white sheet and bars. Drag rappers while they white beat up. From a king, so we drag those stupid. So I'ma go stupid. Made this city cap a drop top. Almost mini cooked it. Stick shift, automatic, automatic. They could round clip. Get it, nigga, while I die. Yeah.
It's me again, all I be is when. Never if you see a lens, it's probably CNN. Or get fucking rat-a-tatter, your brain matter gets scattered and served up on a platter. They call it data, baiting cappers. I'm more like beta cap, I'm great. Like your great-great-grandma and Nate. What to protect with this great late grandma's rivers. That's why I gotta be called. Decide if you fall or have the wherewithal to break outside of the law and fight for we yours. We 100 deep, don't give a fuck about your capacity. They tell me who they favorite, I ain't hating, but they trash me. Y'all know this is my world, so I'ma hold it down like gravity. I'm fighting, that's a casualty. I'm blowing out your cavities. Keep the pocket rocker for the people. Pocket watch and pull up with a Glock and cock. Got you begging out to pop it. That gotta stop. I want more cash and more fast. I want on the run like I old
you
jazz for more bass.
What? My mindset is too meticulous. Yeah. Rhymes melt when I sing like the wings from Kid Icarus. Dig every rap is indicative. Diction is like addiction. I'm ditching the status quo to inhabit flows that I stitched in. Get up. Pitching garments. Each comment is like a gauntlet. A conscious effort to execute rap.
I'm just
trying
to test.
Testament. Exit through my excrement. Through my intestine. Intestinal fortitude, afforded you. It's what you
down with smoke, but stay with a cig like Mary Kay Dawson. Cause my picture showed us the breeze of the roses. I ain't a fashion overmodel to swallow rappers for follow. Just for mentions on blogs, but blogs like Anna Apollo. But keep the tuli. Pockets blue like Tuki. Patience short as Uzi. You a groupie, you a red like Mickey. You move like a goofy, out your goofy. Yeah, you out your top. Thinking you gon' move me. You like Suki. You suck dick for chips. I'm too rich and choosy.
I ain't gotta tell you what I've done, who I am, or where I'm from. If you don't know it by now, then you just dumb. I ain't got no pistol. I'm the girl, lean beans on the bankroll. I buy shares, land, LLCs, payroll. Kuwaiti and Bahraini do not go booyah, mutual funds, nigga. Fuck a dollar and a peso. I got seven investors that'll invest when I say so.
Hey yo, Max A lines, I wrote this spin in the yard though. Foul Maki, villainous Queens, Lance Furtado. Mean face, Marcialago. Oregon flow, salute that. Shit on schedule like it's Juma. I don't do the work. I just stuff bags, the bad shooters, let the forest skirt. Squeeze semi and let it squirt. Artifacts on the chow now, getting rich off of merch. Laser beam dot, I turn niggas' phone process to red bottom.
Yeah, I'm underrated and I never show my soul. And I never switch lane that sounds southern when the game changed. Niggas say they real till you see them on the real. Then you find out they a bitch ass nigga just with a record deal. For real, the internet gon' get these niggas killed. Hide behind that keyboard, cuz gon' get some blood spilled. Your insecurity gon' make this 4-5. Open up your mind and bring enlightenment. And then you have more clarity.
If I roll 100 deep, it's 200 fists, 200 feet, at least 100 guns. So any nigga get one apiece. Bitch, I'll piss on the tombstone when you underneath. This sick, don't play this shit if your stomach weak. I can stomach beef, I done face danger. I squeeze like a waist trainer, then you a loose stomach meat. I run the street, so a cat skiing at me, and it gotta get shot like a mandatory vaccine.
Out of sight, out of mind, till I creep up behind. Double barrel shots, got everything on your mind. Think of that, like the next line you're trying to consider. But you careful so you dumb down, you ain't no spitter. Then you post, you got beef, dummy, you ain't no hitter. You a tweeter, who mouth flame more than his heater. From the days of the park chance, blowing the tweeters. Rugged raps with a DJ, cutting the meters.
Get him.
Let me give you facts, before Cash App. I was frontin' niggas working, they was bringing cash back. Before Instagram, was selling them Instagrams. Connect them in the kin, never fuck with no middleman. But for the fake jury and niggas with all the cap and 40 carats in my Philly beef, nigga was all platinum. You little niggas in the way, this $1 million paydays. Me and my nigga pay slaves.
It's the West Coast of New York and low riding, crip walking, nigga. Anyone can get it, mass like the pandemic. Niggas mad I don't pick up, I got multiple phones. Flake took a month to find me, got multiple homes. Pop off, my black talents are bully and fast. 300 blackout, fully suppressed. Cut through your cold crew like a saw blade. Then up in Mr. Chow's eating sauteed.
Jersey Colonel, with an inferno, inferno, any chicken with friction with rhyme trying. Kidnap the colonel, trigger tribal, trigger fingers, trigger not treacherous. Sure. Double shots of extortion, extra shots for an exorcist. Exorcise my freedom, beat them when I meet them, eat them. Even when the odds ain't even, I get even. With K-Slay, fuck they
replay, the rebirth and replay. Mr. Slap your favorite DJ and sell his chains on eBay. It's Jerk!
Top billing, how we kids mowing milk shit. Brownie crownies did all the dirt in the filth with. Yeah. My young buck days was on a real strip. Film more slim shit, straight off a film strip. I ran through more fine women that wilted it. Superstars, Ken Fills, bitches with some soft and silk lips. Made a killing off of Dylan that real fix. Numbers like a pinball wizard to the top shit.
I'm a product of Frank White. Whoever acted tough gets stage frights. Give them clear vision of grave sights. So get my cake right. Something in the bacon that ain't light. Or something in your face that it ain't light. So don't play with me. Hell gates await. When I come to the eighth, I shoot it faithfully. And tell mates to pray for me. Play with an AK, nigga. That's my specialty. Brooklyn forever. Mafia to the death of me.
For my next verse, I done left Earth. The internet done tripled my net worth off a sweatshirt. Expert, I let the text work. Your neck shirt, been a devil. Bench press metal, I'm doing chest work. One of the deepest, and you've been warned. Please believe you're now looking at Jesus in human form. Snap, leave, respect me like you speak in the school of brawn. The newest legend in the league, I leave with my shooting arms.
All you assholes finished, I don't have those limits. You'll get this work in all black, it's a black owned business. But you cats don't get it, that's why I'm stunting on you newbies. Your father was a super fan, your mother was a groupie. That's why I trip like, who you trying to rap with? Sounding nothing like yourself, who you trying to catfish? Like you bodied that shit, shut your lying ass lips. Do it look like I've been playing, nigga, call it Kaepernick.
Motherfucker got the memo, murder game is my M.O. Back in front line, not from out of the window. Take your life and take your jewels for a memento. To make it to the outro, you gotta bang from the intro. Like a nympho, ain't fucking around, I ain't. Shoot a short shot like AD in the paint. Don't need a long stick, just a 38 and I'm straight. One dome shot, that's how I show restraint.
Bit like damn, we ain't heard from you in a minute. Shit, get grace in my presence, see, bitch, I'm gifted. Said it's only right, they calling me cold. See, I'm the sickest. I heard it just like curse. A lot of you hoes are scripted. Don't get it twisted. Me and you, what's the difference? I'm a superstar. You role playing bitches is pippin'. Oh, and did I mention? Keep me about your mentions. You bitches ain't soldiers. Y'all just be wanting attention.
Hey, yo, New York, get the money. Five birds of death. My dude was caught with some money. Five birds and meth. Who bought me? Bugs Bunny, iceberg, and sweats. First baguettes. Big stepper, learn the steps. Earn respect, but connects, cause my word was kept. Swerve the vet, like Sean Poe, thermal mess. And firm and sweat. Like I don't spit, burn the best. Truth, Tupac juice, like I served them wet.
Promise I was privatized before I was italicized. Any job, nigga, I am overqualified. I'm the kind of nigga whose cloth would be hard to find. Integrity, I put mine over dollar signs. A nigga play me, then he out his mind. As long as my niggas is winning, I ain't gotta shine. If you can't see I'm a G, then you kinda blind. Die before you disrespect me, nigga, bottom line.
Time at the barbaric, barbarian, bar spitter, bar none. Bar guns, ballin' like bar miss, you bar none. Your bar's done, I'm barrific, my bar's gifted. Real rapper, my bar's Christmas. Cook like a bar and grill, I spit these bars in your grill. Homer, Bluehead, keep a mag, I'm bar Simpson. My bar's mentioned, muscle bars, I'm bar benching. Ted dancing, have a beer and cheer, these bars pimpin'.
I see these niggas' blessings. I ain't one of the best at this, and wonder why I'm attacking the mic like a pessimist.